Good afternoon. Welcome to Daily Currency Update from the Currency Desk. Today, in terms of the rupee against the dollar, we have witnessed some appreciation in the dollar. That means the rupee has weakened a lot. The main reason for this is the disappointing speech from the US Federal Reserve Chairman Ben Bernanke. They have not given any cues as regards to any QE3. Markets had a lot of quantitative easing 3 expectations, mainly because the US data was constantly coming in negative and the economy was constantly moving towards a slowdown. Hence, there were some upside measures, some growth measures expected to be implemented by the Federal Reserve. But again, as said before, the Federal Reserve Chairman has again said that currently it would not opt for any quantitative easing, but at the same time, if required, later on they would put in some effective measures in order to boost the growth. But due to the lack of cues about QE in the current period, right now the markets have taken the news negatively, and in the morning session we had the Asian equities also trading negative. This in turn has also affected the local equity markets, and at the same time we are witnessing some depreciation in the rupee rate. This US Federal Reserve Chairman's speech has also overshadowed the fact that China, for the first time since 2008, has come up with a rate cut. This rate cut was mainly done so as to boost the growth in the Chinese economy, but this was very well overlooked by the markets when Mr. Bernanke came out with his statement. Currently in dollar we have a very bullish view, and we recommend a fresh buy at current levels, and one can keep a target of 57.86 in the spot levels. Coming to the European front, we had quite a few events. Firstly, the Spanish and the French bond auctions. Both bond auctions were successful in terms of raising funds. They could raise as much funds as they had targeted, but they were distinct in one manner, that is the yields. The Spanish yield constantly increased, and the overall average yield was well above 6%. So one side we had the overcoming of fears that Spain could not sell its bonds, and the bonds would not be bought by the public, but at the same time the borrowing costs have gone up. So one side, the fears of Spain not being able to raise funds through a bond auction were wiped out from the market. On the other end, the yields, that is the borrowing costs, have also increased. But when we compare this with the French auction, not only did they meet their target sales, but also they were able to reduce the yields. The French bond yields went down to a lifetime low. This indicated that people were shifting towards a lower risk economies. At the same time, according to an IMF report, the Spanish banks now require around $50 billion to actually restructure their banks and bring back life into their banking system. So this again states that there is a huge fund requirement by the Spanish economy. Until and unless this is not met, we'll still have ongoing troubles in the European economy. But as the auction results were better than expected, we had some support in the euro, and we saw the euro move above 1.25 levels. This upside movement was also seen in the rate of euro against the Indian rupee. Currently, we recommend a fresh buy at current levels and keep a target of 71.28 in the spot levels. Coming to the UK front, the pound was boosted by the upside movement in the euro, and it seemed to trail the movement of the euro, though not proportionately but to a great extent. In terms of the UK economy, the Bank of England kept key rates unchanged, and also the targeted quantitative easing were kept the same, that is as per the earlier statements. They also gave no further quantitative easing clues. Due to this, there was not a major upside movement in the pound, but at the same time there was some rally seen in the pound. Against the rupee, we expect pound to rally a bit, but unless there is any major triggers, it would remain sideways between the range of 84.83 and 86.07 in the spot levels. Coming to the Japanese economy, we had the Japanese GDP figures coming up in the morning. Earlier they had come at 1% and now they have been revised upside to 1.2%. Though there was an upside revision, the Japanese GDP figures are yet not as per expectations, and at the same time we had the trade surplus in the Japanese economy decrease. As we had stated earlier, that due to the increase in import, the surplus would be impacted. But what was unexpected is the surplus actually reduced by 21%, which is a huge figure. So this is slightly negative for the Japanese economy, or we can say the Japanese yen against the dollar. So when the Japanese yen is moving down against the dollar, we also expect some downside against the Indian rupee. We recommend, based on technicals, a fresh short at current levels and keep a target of 67.50 in the spot. Thank you.